My name is Vandecci Gonzo, and I'm the CEO and founder of Vandecci's Vault. Today, I wanted to talk to you guys about the different kinds of full moons. So first, let's talk about the wolf moon. The full moon in January is the wolf moon, named after howling wolves, which may stem from the Anglo-Saxon lunar calendar. There are other names for the wolf moon, such as the moon after Yule, the old moon, the ice moon, and the snow moon. Next up, let's talk about the snow moon. So, the snow moon is the full moon in February, named after the snowy conditions. Some North American tribes named it the hunger moon due to the scarce food sources during midwinter. While other names are the storm moon and chaste moon. Next, let's talk about the worm moon. So the last full moon of the winter season in March is the worm moon because of the earthworms that come out at the end of winter. It is also known as the crow moon and the crust moon, the sap moon, the sugar moon, and the chaste moon. And the old English Anglo-Saxon name is the Lenten moon. Now let's talk about the pink moon. The full moon in April is the pink moon from the pink flowers that bloom in the early spring. Other names for this full moon includes the sprouting grass moon, the fish moon, the hair moon, and the English Anglo-Saxon name is the egg moon. It is also known as the Paschal moon because it is used to calculate the date for Easter. Now let's talk about the flower moon. So the May full moon is known as the flower moon to signify that bloom during this month. Other names for the full moon in May are the corn planting moon and the milk moon. And again, this is from Old English Anglo-Saxon. Now let's talk about the strawberry moon. So June's full moon is called the strawberry moon, as these little red berries ripen during this time. Other names are the hot moon, the mead moon, and the rose moon. Next up is the buck moon. The full moon for the month of July is called the buck moon to signify the new antlers that emerges on deer bucks' foreheads around this time. This full moon is also known as the thunder moon, the wart moon, and the hay moon from Old English Anglo-Saxon. Next up is the sturgeon moon. So the full moon of August is called the sturgeon moon. And this is because of the large number of fish in the lakes where the Algonquin tribes used to fish. Other names for this full moon includes the green corn moon, the barley moon, the fruit moon, and the grain moon. So now let's talk about the harvest moon. So technically the harvest moon is the full moon closest to the September equinox. Around September 22nd. Most years, it's in September, but around every 3 years, it's in October. And the harvest moon is the only full moon name that is determined by the equinox rather than the month. So now let's talk about the corn moon. The full moon in the month of September is called the corn moon. So the full moon in the month of September in the Old Farmer's Almanac is called the harvest moon, which corresponds with the Old English / Anglo-Saxon name, the corn moon, or full corn moon, or barley moon. Now let's talk about the hunter's moon. So every 3 years, the hunter's moon is also the harvest moon. So traditionally, people in the Northern Hemisphere spent the month of October preparing for the coming winter by hunting, slaughtering and preserving meats for use as food. This led to October's full moon being called the hunter's moon, or the dying grass moon, the sanguine moon, or the blood moon. However, this should not be confused with a total lunar eclipse blood moon. Now let's talk about the beaver moon. So according to folklore, the full moon in November is named after beavers who became active preparing for the winter. It is also known as the frosty moon. And along with the December full moon, some call it the oak moon. So traditionally, if the Beaver Moon is the last full moon before the winter solstice, it is also called the Morning Moon. Now, last but not least, let's talk about the Cold Moon. So December is the month when winter begins for most of the Northern Hemisphere, and thus the full moon is called the Cold Moon. The Old English Anglo-Saxon name is the moon before the Yule, while another name is the Wolf Moon. However, this is not only by definition of a blue moon. About every 19 years, there is no full moon in February. This is one of the several definitions of the term black moon. The other definitions refer to a new moon, which does not fit in with the equinoxes or the solstices, similar to the blue moon. So let's go over what I just said. January has the wolf moon, and February has the snow moon. March has the worm moon, April has the pink moon, May has the flower moon, June has the strawberry moon, July has the buck moon, August has the sturgeon moon. The harvest moon is in between September and October, whilst September has the corn moon, and October has the hunter's moon. November has the beaver moon. And last but not least, December has the cold moon. So thank you so much for watching this video. And if you would like to watch other videos like this one, please go to my website, www.vandecci.com. See you there. Thanks for watching. Bye.